Hi, my lovies. How are you today? My name is Marlene Schaefer, and I have lost 230 pounds. I was 390, now I'm 160. I'm passionate about bringing you guys these videos to tell you guys about things that I didn't know losing weight so you guys won't make the same mistakes that I made. If you want to know what this video is about, please stay tuned. We're back. You can follow my hashtag here at Marlene Schaefer Journey, and you can see my whole weight loss journey up until this video. Okay, this video is about confidence as a plus size woman. Even now, even then, when I was 330, my mama always taught me to be confident in myself. Even now, I'm the same person. I have not changed. My size changed, but I haven't changed. I have a couple tips that may help a lot of you that have low self-esteem. I'm just trying to help you gain some self-esteem. If I can help one person through my videos, I'm happy. Compliment other plus size women. But not just plus size women, just other women in general. You boost their confidence and you make your confidence feel good because you compliment someone. It's nothing wrong with you compliment another lady. If you can compliment her and make her feel good, you making yourself feel good because you making her feel good. Compliment her. You know, don't be scared to give another woman a compliment. We all ladies and we all need that boost and encouragement. For a lot of you that don't have confidence, never compare yourself. Never, ever, ever, ever compare yourself to anyone because you your own person. You do not have the same DNA. You do not have the same talent. You do not have the same fingerprints. You're not like anyone in this world. It's a scientific fact that we are unique and we cannot compare ourselves with other people. God made us unique. God made us our own person. He knows everything about us. So embrace that. Don't knock that under the rug and wish you were somebody else because He made them for them. He made you for you. I embrace getting naked. Yes, I do. Even when I was 390 pounds, I embrace getting naked because it's your sexuality. You feel sexy. Don't be shy and scared of love handles. God created those love handles for you. Embrace your love handles. If someone can accept you for you being you, they simply don't need you. I have saggy skin. I do, but strangely, I still love myself. I still look at myself in the mirror and think I'm the finest woman on earth. You have to have that confidence. You have to install that in yourself. Because if you don't, who will? Spend more time by yourself. Give yourself time to collect your thoughts, collect your feelings, collect your emotions, collect everything that you need to pray and ask God for. Strength, good encouragement, good confidence. Ask Him to work on you. I may be contradicting myself a little bit, but I'm going to explain why. Trust and believe, I have a good explanation for it. You can spend time by yourself and you can go all out often. Now, these are for these people who need to build up their confidence around people. I mean, everybody need that time alone. And everybody do still need to be in society and, you know, maneuver with people because you can't always be alone. Make sure you have that time alone before you give your time to anybody else. Do you. Make sure you have encouraging friends, very supportive friends like me. I try to encourage you to lose weight. I'm trying to encourage you to be more confident. I'm trying to encourage you to be more happy with yourself. You know, you have to have those type of friends around you to help encourage you, to help motivate you, to help push you. You don't need nobody to sabotage you. You don't need somebody always talking about you. You don't need that person that's toxic in your life. You don't need someone that's not good for you. You need encouraging people. Like, if I can encourage one person to lose weight, if I can encourage one heavy girl to have high self-esteem, if I can encourage one person who's not even trying to lose weight to feel good for yourself, I'm happy. I found one of my callings in life, you know. Always love yourself. Always. Stand in the mirror often. If you avoid the mirror, that's not healthy. Don't avoid the mirror. It's you. Embrace you. Talk to yourself in the mirror. Pray to yourself in the mirror. Tell yourself that you're beautiful. Tell yourself that I love me. I love you. Do that, you know. Have confidence in yourself. You know, you have to look at yourself every day of your life, and you must love yourself for you to feel good about yourself. You can't hate yourself because you have to live with yourself every day. Don't you think that's miserable, to live in a body that a person don't like? So even if you can't lose a pound, even if you cannot change your skin color, even if you cannot change your big nose, you don't have money to have surgery, you don't have money to change anything about yourself, brace yourself. Love what he created. Love, it's like a sculpture. And, you know, he carved this out. He made you exactly the way he wanted you to be. Like a heart. That heart that comes like this. He made a heart to be shaped like an heart. He made you to be shaped like you. Embrace it. I cannot stress that enough. Embrace you. Make a list of all of your accomplishments. All of your accomplishment and all of your talent. Sometimes we can take that for granted. You don't know how powerful you is. You know, I'm still amazed when I build something. I'm amazed. With God's help, my persistency, my consistent, he let your girl do that. Don't be embarrassed of yourself. Love yourself. Do the best you can with what you got. If you never lose a pound, if you never can do anything, you know, if you never can change yourself, love what you have. So that's it, my lovies. I love you guys to pieces. Ooh, you guys make me so happy. Mwah. 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 Bye bye.
Thank you for watching. Please have a blessed day.